For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hello and welcome to People's Dispatch. You are watching Around the World in 8 Minutes, where we cover worker resistance and popular movements around the globe. Today we are reporting from the ground in New Delhi, right in front of Gopal Rai, Delhi Labour Minister's house. Various trade unions have united against the increasing number of fires in factories in the nation's capital. Several trade union activists and workers are demonstrating right in front of his house, demanding the implementation of safety regulation in factories. Just last year in January 20, Delhi witnessed one of the most terrible factory fires in Bhavana industrial area, where reportedly more than 40 workers were killed. This was because the owner of the factory had locked the doors from outside to force the workers to work overtime. Despite this fire, neither property safety measures were implemented nor employers were held accountable. Delhi continues to witness major factory fires till today.
You see, there is a similar pattern wherever these incidents are happening in Delhi. First of all, Delhi is a capital, and these are the state of affairs in the capital itself. There are 31 confirming industrial centers in Delhi, and the story is repeated again and again. The owners are taking work by locking the main gates of the industries. They have only single entry and exit points. No proper staircase, no proper ventilation, and all these are to be complied under Factories Act. There is a factory manual already existing as per the labor laws, but the owners are not complying with the labor laws itself. So it is the responsibility of the Delhi government and labor department functioning under the Delhi government. We have protested today because incidents are happening again and again in Delhi. We had a meeting last year also in Delhi Secretariat, in which minimum wage compliance, safety and other issues were there. And some decisions were taken. But we are annoyed that those decisions are not being implemented by the Delhi government itself. So it's a good that Labour Minister, he himself came to our protest. But the thing is, we want concrete actions from the Delhi government side. And these should be visible. Like we have mentioned, are these workers are covered under ESIC or not? Because incidents might happen, it might not be a mistake of the owner also. But whether the workers of that particular industry are covered by ESIC, because ECIC has a provision for accidents and compensation and all those things. But that has to be checked, inspected in the industries all over Delhi. So we want concrete actions from the Labour Department, from Delhi government, from Gopal Rai, so that there should be some check on the future incidents in the capital itself.
It's the same story that happened in Nawada. It's the same story that happened in Mundka, in Sultanpuri. So we see that at various levels. See, we are living in strange times. We have a government at the center which says that to help businessmen increase their profits, which they actually try to camouflage as ease of doing business. They say that to help them in ease of doing business, we need to abolish these laws, these archaic laws, and we'll have these four new labor codes. But what is the actual situation? This is what the central government is saying. The actual situation is that when these laws are existing on ground, they are not being implemented within 20 kilometers of radius of this parliament where they are going to abolish these laws. This is a state government in Delhi, which supposedly is always at loggerheads with the central government. But when it comes to workers, when it comes to the cause of the workers, we see that they are equally responsible for causing this. We have seen that even after the incident that happened in Bawana, where 17 workers, this is what the government says, 17 workers. The workers had a different account. They said there were at least 40 workers. So even after that incident, when trade unions jointly gave a memorandum to Gopal Rai, from that date, it has been now around 18 months and these incidents are not stopping. If I'll just give a list of incidents, it's January 2018, we have Bawana, 17 dead. It's then in February we have Karol Bagh, 1 dead. Then we have Narela in April, 2 dead. 2 more incidents in April, 4 dead in Sultanpuri, 2 dead in Nawada. Then again we have Karol Bagh in November, 4 dead. Sarup Nagar, 1 dead. Moti Nagar, 6 dead. Narela, 2 dead again. Jhilmil, 3 dead. And this again is a figure that is contested by the workers. The workers from the nearby factories, they have told us that in a shift there were at least 35 to 50 workers. We are not sure how many of them have died. We don't know how the chief minister went there and announced a compensation of 5 lakh rupees. There's no one, entirely no one in this a government machinery, you can say, that how many workers worked in that factory. They have no records, they have no registers. In fact, if you go even today to the factory site, you'll see that these factories don't even have boards. They don't have nameplates in front of the factory. You won't be able to identify which factory is this. What are they manufacturing? Who is the owner of the factory? You won't see compliance boards as per the Minimum Wages Act. You won't see any kind of compliance of any kind of labor law.
Thank you, Aditi. We now go to Puerto Rico, where over the past couple of days, the Boricuan people on the island and across the diaspora have been mobilizing en masse to demand the resignation of Governor Ricardo Rosselló. The agitations have also strengthened the calls for the decolonization of the island. On July 17th, organizations are planning a major demonstration to the residence of the governor. These protests were triggered by a combination of two events. First, 6 people, including 2 former officials in Rosselló's administration, were arrested by the US Federal Bureau of Investigation on corruption charges. Then, the details of a group chat involving Rosselló and his associates was leaked by the Puerto Rico-based Center for Investigative Journalism. The group chats revealed shocking details of the insensitivity and crudeness of those at the highest echelons of power. In it, Rosselló and his advisors talk about how to manage the political narrative through the media and boost the image of the governor and the administration through the manipulation of political polls. The chats also reveal that the governor and his brothers used extremely sexist, misogynist and homophobic jokes and language while discussing other politicians, journalists, social movements and collectives, and even members of the Fiscal Control Board. There were even jokes made about the over 4,640 people who died in the aftermath of Hurricane Maria. The corruption charges against the 6 individuals involved the misdirection of $15 million worth of Medicaid and federal education funds. The 2 incidents were the last straw for the people of Puerto Rico, who continue to suffer nearly 2 years after Hurricane Maria. Activists have pointed out that the devastation and the slow recovery after the hurricane was directly related to Puerto Rico's position as a colony of the United States. That's all we have for this episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes. To read more about the stories, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org and follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Thanks for watching.